here, because we are talking about a limit question, so this 0 over 0 is an indeterminate form. We don't know what the answer yet unless we do more work. So what's the difference between undefined versus indeterminate? And in particular, we would like to know, do we say 0 over 0 as undefined, or do we say 0 over 0 as indeterminate? In order to answer that question, we will have to first know that when do we use undefined and when do we use indeterminate. Let me tell you. For undefined, this is the case when we are not doing any limits, when we are not doing any calculus. This right here is just when we are doing regular computation. Of course, on the other hand, we can guess it. Indeterminate is when we are doing limits in calculus. So let me write that down right here. For limits in calculus. And another thing to keep in mind is that sometimes we can just write down the word undefined as the answer, such as if we are trying to do 5 divided by 0, we don't have an answer for that. You just write down undefined as the answer, as the response, and move on. But you never write down indeterminate as an answer for a limit question. Indeterminate is just a form that indicates that we have to do more work in order to determine the answer. And 0 over 0 is one of the indeterminate forms. And we have a total of 7 right here. Let me give you guys an example to make everything super clear. So let me say, let a function be, let's say x minus 3 over x squared minus 8x plus 15. Part A, let's go ahead and figure out what's f of 3. What does this notation mean? It means that x is exactly equal to 3, and we just have to plug in 3 into all the x's here. So we are going to get 3 minus 3 over 3 squared minus 8 times 3, and then plus 15. On the top, we get 0. And on the bottom, this is 9 minus 24, which is negative 15. Plus 15, we get 0. So as you can see, we have a 0 over 0. So what do we do? Well, it's just a regular computation. As long as we have 0 on the bottom, we can just say it's undefined and then move on. So here, we answer it as undefined. And then done. That's it. No other things that you have to do. But once we get to limit, it's a little bit trickier. So let's say if we have the limit as x approaching 3. Keep in mind, when x is approaching 3, we are not saying x is exactly equal to 3. X could be like 2.999 or 2.9999. It's getting closer and closer to 3, and I want to see the behavior of the function. And then, of course, let me write down x minus 3 over x squared minus 8x plus 15. So this is what we usually do. X is approaching 3, 2.9999, or maybe 3.001. But you know, if you plug in those numbers, unless you have a calculator, otherwise it's pretty hard to compute this in your head, right? So what we do first is just plug in 3 into all the x's and see what happens. Because if you end up with a nice number, that will be a nice answer. But let's see, when we plug in 3 into all the x's, we get 3 minus 3 over 3 squared minus 8 times 3, and then plus 15. Of course, this will give us 0 on the top, and then also 0 on the bottom. We did that over there already. But here, because we are talking about a limit question, so this 0 over 0 is an indeterminate form. We don't know what the answer yet unless we do more work. And the biggest difference is that this is when x is exactly equal to 3. And this is x is approaching 3, such as 3.0001, and we'll maybe get even closer, 3.0000001. Anyway, so let's see how we can figure out the answer. We'll notice that on the bottom, we have a quadratic. We can factor it, actually. So let's say we have the limit as x approaching 3. On the top, we have x minus 3. On the bottom, factor it, we get x minus 3 times x minus 5. Look, x minus 3 cancels out with that x minus 3. In fact, I will tell you a secret. If you have a limit question when x is approaching 3, then you can expect to cancel the factor x minus 3, x minus 3, if it was a 0 over 0 case earlier. And now, we did cancel out the x minus 3, meaning we did cancel the 0 over 0 case. And again, this is when x is not equal to 3. So what we are going to say is, this will be equal to the limit as x approaching 3 of the rest, 1 over x minus 5. Well, now, let's go ahead and plug in this 3 into this x and see what happens. I'm plugging this number in, so no more limit symbol, and then I get 1 over 3 minus 5, and can we work this out? Yes, this is just a regular number, and that will be our answer, and we get negative 1/2. That's it.